Welcome to the Tiller Review Channel. Today we're taking a look at the Klein K12035 Heavy Duty Wire Stripper. Now, as you can see, this is a part of the Klein Curve series, where their handles are curved to fit better in your hand. And this wire stripper will strip from 8 to 20 gauge AWG wire. So to start off the video here, you can see you have the blue and gray accent comfort grip style of handles on these wire strippers. And you can see you have the Klein name that is a part of the molding and stamped with gray paint or plastic to make it differentiate from the blue handles. And as you can see right here, you have Made in the USA stamped there as well. And then you have some safety warnings on this side of the tool. It's obviously not going to protect you from electrical shock. Wear approved safety glasses and never use it on a live circuit. Then coming up to this tool, the business end of the tool, you have Made in the USA laser etched onto there. And I believe this H6 is a production code. And then you have this opening right here, which I feel Klein should have put a lock right there. But you have the model number right there, and you have a spring right there as well, because this tool is spring loaded. So you have your model number right there, which is the K12035. And then you have your Klein logo with the guy on the telephone pole. You got the Klein name and established 1857. And then you have your two screw cutting holes right here. So you have your 632 and your 832 screw cutting holes right there. And now if we move up to here, you can see we have a shear style of cutters right there. And they are only meant for cutting copper wire. And then if you come up to here, you have your scale of different wires that this tool can strip. So for the solid scale, you can go from 8 to 18 gauge solid. And then on the stranded side, you can go from 10 to 20 gauge stranded. And then coming to the nose of the plier, you have a good knurling or cross-hatching design right there on the nose. So if you really needed to grip on to something or you were, you know, twisting some wires together, that cross-hatching design is going to allow you to get a nice grip onto the pliers. And then coming to the back side of the pliers, it's relatively simple. There's no laser etching to tell you which is which on the back side. There's nothing really too exciting on this side. Pretty much the same. The handles are pretty much the same as the other side. Now, like I said, I would like to have seen Klein put a lock right here. I believe this is just supposed to be now a wire looping hole. It would have been nice to see Klein put a lock right there because, you know, you could use these jaws up here to loop wire if you needed to. Would have been nice to see them put a lock right there so that way when you have it in your tool bag, it stays shut. But that's really so far my only complaint. So we'll go ahead and zoom out here and we'll get to some of the functionality. We'll get to the business end of this tool, which is mainly for stripping wire and cutting wire. So we're going to first start off with some 18 gauge stranded wire. So for the 18 gauge stranded wire, we're going to be using that second from the top stripping hole. So we'll go ahead and stick this guy in there and see how well and easy we can pull off that insulation. And as you can see right there, pulled off that insulation from this 18 gauge stranded wire, no problem whatsoever. And as you can see, we are able to cut through it, no problem whatsoever. So go ahead and reinsert that guy there. And as you can see again, you can pull off that 18 gauge insulation, no problem whatsoever, and chop it off fairly easy. So go ahead and get that stuff out of the way. And we'll bring in our 18 gauge solid wire, which is going to be this very top stripping hole right there. So we'll go ahead and stick this guy in there and see how easy it is to pull off that insulation. As you see right there, you are able to pull it off no problem whatsoever, and you're able to cut that 18 gauge solid wire no problem at all. And as you can see, we were able to strip it off there super easy. So we'll go ahead and cut that off and set that to the side. And now we will bring in our 14 gauge solid wire. So for 14 gauge solid wire, you can see we're going to be using one of the stripping holes in the middle of the tool. So we'll go ahead and get that little piece of insulation out of there. We'll go ahead and line up our tool and we'll pull off that insulation. You see right there, we're able to pull it off. I did kind of nick the wire right there, so I'm gonna go ahead and try that one more time. So go ahead and cut that guy off and line up the correct size stripping hole right there. And as you see right there, you are able to pull off that insulation, no problem. And then if you needed to, you could use the hole right there to loop your wire if you needed to. Probably should have stripped a little bit more off of it, but as you saw right there, that's kind of how that little looping hole works. So go ahead and clear that stuff out of there. And now we'll bring in our 12 gauge solid wire, excuse me. So solid wire is again going to be one of those middle holes right there. So go ahead and line that up. As you see right there, you're able to pull off that insulation, no problem. And you're able to cut through that 12 gauge solid wire, no problem whatsoever. So we'll go ahead and do that one more time. As you see, we're able to pull it off, no problem. And we're going to actually pull a little bit more off. As you can see, kind of messed that one up a little bit. So we'll go ahead and reinsert that guy right there and pull off that insulation. And we'll insert that guy down here. And we'll use that little hole down there to loop some wire, as you can see right there. And we'll go ahead and cut that guy off. So we'll go ahead and get that stuff out of the background. And now we're going to bring in some stranded wire. So we're going to start off with some 14 gauge stranded wire. So for obviously 14 gauge stranded wire, it's going to be that 12 gauge solid hole. It's going to be one of those metal holes again. And as you can see right there, we are able to pull off that insulation from that stranded wire, no problem whatsoever. And there's no damage done to the conductors there on the inside of the wire, or the copper, I should say. And as you can see right there, you are able to pull it off, no problem whatsoever. So we'll go ahead and cut that guy off and set that wire off to the side. And we'll bring in some 12 gauge stranded wire right here. So we're going to be using the second from the bottom hole now for this stranded wire. And we'll go ahead and pull off that insulation. And as you saw right there, pulls off the insulation and cuts out that insulation super clean. And it does it, you know, you're able to pull it off super easy as well. So we'll go ahead and do that one more time. And as you see right there, we're able to pull it off, no problem whatsoever. And you're able to cut through it, no problem whatsoever. So we'll go ahead and get that off and bring in our last wire here. Now we'll bring in our 10 gauge stranded wire and see if we can cut through this and pull off that insulation. So go ahead and pull down on that. Definitely have to use a little bit of force to pull off that insulation, but as you can see right there, you are able to pull it off. And it does a relatively nice, good job, you know, pulling off the insulation and make it nice and clean looking. So we'll go ahead and chop that guy off and we'll be able to do that test one more time. And we'll go ahead and pull off that insulation, as you saw right there. And we'll go ahead and cut that guy off, no problem. Now, we're going to bring in some multi-conductor wires. I'm not going to strip them. I'm just going to see how strong those cutting jaws are. So we have some 14-2 with ground Romex right here, which is, you know, two 14-gauge wires plus the ground wire. And as you see right there, those jaws can cut through that no problem whatsoever. So go ahead and set that off to the side. And we'll bring in our final wire right here, which is the 12-2 with ground, and see how well we can cut through this. Definitely have to use a little bit more force, but as you see right there, the cutting jaws are able to cut through all three of those conductors at once, and yes, it's fairly easy as well. So overall, these are definitely a nice pair of wire strippers from Klein. Again, the model number is K12035. Like I said, the really only complaint I have with these is I really wish they would just put a lock there so that you could keep it locked in the tool bag instead of, you know, having it sprung open and taking up a lot of room. But overall, these are definitely a nice pair of wire strippers. Now, you should be able to find these at your local Home Depot. They're not going to be in the normal tool section. You're going to have to go to the electrical section. You should find them over there. That's generally where most of the Klein tools are, at least in my Home Depot, are all in the electrical section. And these are, there's going to be three different varieties of wire strippers you can get there, and this is one of them. Definitely a nice pair of wire strippers, especially if you need one, you lose it on the job, or you break it on the job and you went in a pinch. You know, there's a Home Depot pretty much in every town, so you can just run there and pick these guys up if they have it in stock. But if you don't want to go and pick it up at Home Depot, I will leave a link to Klein's website in the description below. That'll take you right up to the product page for this guy. You can look up some more information about this tool. And you can also find some online retailers that have this tool as well, or some, I should say, some online authorized Klein retailers that'll have this tool. It's very important to buy from an authorized dealer, because if you do end up breaking the tool, you know, it carries a lifetime warranty on the tool. But if you do end up breaking the tool, in the warranty process, you're going to have to show proof of where you bought it before Klein will send you a new replacement. And I believe it has to be from an authorized dealer. But that's, I'll see if I can find a link to Klein's warranty information down in the description. I'll try to see if I can leave that down in the description, as well as the product page for this guy as well. But that's really about it for this video. So if you have any questions, comments, concerns, please feel free to leave them down in the comment section below. And if you're new to the channel and you would like to check out more videos like this or see more videos like this, please consider hitting that subscribe button. And if you did enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up as well. But that's all I have. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for the next video to be uploaded.